Signal Race fans getting ready to go today. 25 laps. It'll be the youngster Logan Robertson and the veteran at Piney Flats, Tennessee, in the TNT race car. It'll be the 83 of Jensen Ford. They'll bring them to green out of turn number four. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's kick off 2017 Dirt Style. It is showtime at the gap. Heading to turn number one, they'll go three wide for the lead down the back straightaway. Jensen Ford on the top side, he'll take it. Robertson will fall back into second. Ballinger working the bottom out of turn number one, out of turn number four. Lap one of 2017 will go to Jensen Ford. Side by side for the runner-up spot down the back straightaway between Robertson, the 29 of Ballinger. Last year's UCRA Late Model Series champion, Drew Kennedy in K37 is fourth, and the Forest Flyer is fifth in 87. Contact off of turn number four, they'll save it. Patience shown by Josh Fields as he let out. Contact with him and Tim Bird down the back straightaway. Into three, out of four, side by side still for second. Robertson slips up the hill, and Ballinger may have the runner-up spot into turn number one. Good racing down the back straightaway. Now the K37. Drew Kennedy watching it all unfold in front of him, trying to challenge for the podium spot at a turn number four. Good racing all over the speedway. Tim Bird is up to fifth now, 24. Steven Martin had problems a couple of laps ago at a turn number four. He's going to be quick to slip into the grasp of Piney Flats, Tennessee's Jensen Ford. And Logan Robertson has got all kinds of problems, pushing all over the racetrack. He's going to lose third. And saves it for now. He'll stay third down the back straightaway. Rusty Ballinger working the extreme bottom of the racetrack. Multiple grooves here today at Volunteer Speedway. Jensen's working the top to the middle. Rusty down on the bottom, digging hard. Good battle for fifth now down the back straightaway. And it'll be Tim Bird who will take it from Walker Arthur out of turn number four. Back into one. Rusty Ballinger that time by about a tenth of a second quicker, a little more than Jensen Ford. He may be running him down as they go into one down the back straightaway. Eight laps scored on the books. It'll be 17 laps to go. Now make it 16 laps to go for Jensen Ford as the Piney Flats drivers fixing to enter heavy lap traffic. Battle for third down the back straightaway as well as fifth. Logan Robertson still receiving heavy pressure from Drew Kennedy as they go into turn number one. And here comes the Forest Flyer out of turn number four for fifth. Down the front straightaway, and Walker Arthur may have it. Down into turn number one. Down the back straightaway, slides up the hill, and here comes Tim Bird off the top side of the speedway. Good side-by-side battles for third and fifth on the racetrack as the leaders enter into lap traffic. 11 in the books now, approaching halfway. And it'll be halfway this lap when we hit the midpoint of the back straightaway. Steven Martin has got problems down the back straightaway. He's off the pace, and he'll fall to the infield. We'll stay green. They get by Kip Sawyer's 44 as they go into turn number one and two. And now Brian Smith's number three car, the next car to go a lap down. Rusty Ballinger has closed in ever so slightly. It's still about six or eight car lengths back from the leader. The battle for third is resolved for the meantime with Logan Robertson settling into third. Bird has fifth over Walker Arthur as the leaders continue to work through heavy lap traffic in the bottom of the speedway. Jensen Ford now dives under the 14 of Lance Reynolds out of turn number four with just 10 laps to go. We've went 15 green here at Volunteer Speedway. Down the back straightaway, one lap car separates your leaders. Down the front straightaway. Back into one and two. Rusty Ballinger trying to get by Lance Reynolds to get up to Jensen Ford and have a shot. Ford now up to the right rear, the left rear corner panel of the 15 of Bryson Dennis as they'll work out at turn number four. Good racing all across the racetrack. Ballinger may have a Lance Reynolds at one and two. He does. Jensen Ford still cannot get by Bryson Dennis. This could be the break he needs. Into three and four. It'll be seven laps to go this time at the line. Bryson Dennis holding Jensen Ford up as he'll go to the top. Ballinger starting to close in, and Jensen's going to use the top to his advantage. He'll go by Bryson Dennis. And it's another lap car that will separate your leaders as they'll come out to turn number four this time. Six laps to go at the line. Field run down now as third will be Logan Robertson. Fourth is Drew Kennedy. And fifth is still Tim Bird. Walker Arthur. Then it is Josh Henry, Chicky Barton, Jesse Lowe, and Josh Fields in 11, your top 10. Jensen Ford now trying to work over Tim Maupin's three car down the back straightaway in the closing laps here. It'll be four laps to go when we get back to the line. Rusty Ballinger looks low to the 15 of Bryson Dennis as the leaders continue to work through lap traffic. Closing into the final circuits now. And Jensen Ford has started to pull some distance on the 29 of Ballinger as Kip Sawyer pulls the 44 to the infield and calls it quits. Two to go signal this time at the stripe for the 83 of Jensen Ford. Oh, big moment there. Three wide down in turn number four with a lap car as the battle for third heats up again. Out of turn number four, it'll be veteran chief starter Terry Gillenwater will show the white cloth. It'll be one lap to go for Jensen Ford. Best battle in a racetrack for third now. Starting to heat up between the 17 of Robertson, the K37 of Drew Kennedy. Final time out of turn number four, your winner, the TNT House car to Piney Flats, Tennessee. It'll be Jensen Ford in 83. Second will go to Ballinger. Third at the line will be Robertson. Fourth to Kennedy, and it'll be fifth, Tim Bird. Sixth is Walker Arthur, seventh, Henry. Eighth, Chicky Barton. Ninth will be Jesse Lowe, and tenth is Josh Fields. He's getting his gear off, climbing out Piney Flats, Tennessee's Jensen Ford, your winner today in the Crate Late Models. Yeah, when they come around next time by, we'll go green for 20 laps. Sportsman late models will be coming up next. Limited late models after the Sportsman and Modified Street will wrap up the day. So it's an all-Kentucky front row with John Stevens out of Wallens, Kentucky, and the 11 of Tim Stevens outside of him out of turn number four. Starting at the cone, and we're underway for the classic feature. Tim Stevens with a good jump off the high side down the back straightaway. He'll take the lead. They went three wide for a moment for third, and it'll be Chesney into turn number three and four out of four. Lap number one's going to go to Harlan, Kentucky's Tim Stevens in 11. That car formerly owned by Knoxville, Tennessee's. And John Stevens battles back to the inside. Down the front straightaway, lap number two, still side by side for the lead into turn number one. Still Tim Stevens at the line. Down the back straightaway, they'll race again, side by side. John Stevens working the inside, 27 feature wins last year. And looking to add to that resume with a win here today in the Volunteer Speedway season opener. Tim Stevens holding the advantage on the top side of the speedway. Chesney is third. Lee Merritt fourth and nine. And down the back straightaway, it'll be the 78 of Richie Overholzer in the top five spot. We got problems in turn two. Car is sideways and the caution is out. Three of 20 laps complete. As Eric Fisher loops the 52 down in turn number two. So it's our first caution flag of the day. So here we go. Coming to green out of turn number four, Tim Stevens will lead us back. And we are underway. Into one and two, they'll go down the back straightaway. Three, four wide down the back straightaway. Chesney making a move on Stevens for second. Down the back straightaway into three and four. Here comes the five of Haston Collette up the middle. Lee Merritt on the top side. It's still Tim Stevens, and then it's a gaggle. Look at Lee Merritt on the outside of turn number one and two down the back straightaway. He's got a run on Josh Chesney for third. John Stevens now back up to the back bumper of the 11 of Tim Stevens. And they'll slip to the outside in turn number one. Battle for the lead down the back straightaway. And John Stevens may have him down the back straightaway. He'll overtake Tim Stevens for the lead. John Stevens overtakes Tim Stevens. And he'll take the lead, Stevens. And Stevens all the front two positions down the back straightaway now. Lee Merritt is third, Chesney fourth. And the five of Haston Collett holds the fifth spot. Side by side is Matt Tharp and Overholzer for sixth, and Tharp will now clear him off the top side as well. Back into turn number one. They'll race down the back straightaway. Still side by side for the sixth position is Overholzer in the 19 of Matt Tharp. And now they have caught the five of Haston Collett. Little bit of contact as he get into turn number one. They'll go three wide. Here comes Tony Trent on the bottom. Good racing mid-pack. Down the back straightaway. Three wide into turn number three and four. How about it? Three wide at the high banks of the Volunteer Speedway. Down the front straightaway, Overholzer gives. Third is still Lee Merritt. Fourth, the one of Chesney. And now they're three wide for fifth, and look at Tony Trent making up big ground on the bottom. He's going to go from ninth to fifth in two laps. It's still John Stevens up front. As we complete 10 laps, Chesney gets sideways in turn number two, and here comes the 19 of Matt Tharp. We knew he was quick in qualifying, second fast, forgot to go to the scales, and the literal left foot has made it to fourth. Into one, down the back. Tony Trent working hard in the bottom of the speedway in 501. Good racing. As the top two have completely pulled away. Oh, hang on, Lee Merritt way up against the wall, and that may cost him. Here comes Tharp for the podium spot. Into turn number one and two, and Matt Tharp will take over third. Just past halfway, eight laps to go. Does he have enough time to run down the leaders? Could he get a caution? Come from the tail to win this feature today. Quick as that 19 car. 15 lapper, that is correct. 15 lapper instead of 20 as they've come out of turn number four, the white flag. One lap to go. Final time around the speedway. Down the back straightaway for John Stevens. Tim Stevens trying to run him down into three and four, but he's not going to be able to do it. Wallens, Kentucky's John Stevens will bring the seven car to victory lane and get the win. Second will go to the 11 of Tim Stevens. Third to Matt Tharp. Good run, Lee Merritt goes fourth, and fifth will be Josh Chesney. So Chesney holds on to fifth. Fourth goes Lee Merritt. Good run from the tail to third for Matt Tharp in 19th, second to Tim Stevens, and your winner. Picking up where he left off last year, big win here today, is first of 2017. How about it for Wallens, Kentucky's John Stevens? A great year last year, looking to back it up in 2017 as he climbs out of the seven car. How about it for Wallens, Kentucky's John Stevens in 7-year winner?
Hey guys, just a reminder on this next pitch, you have seven, the orange seven, he's going to be on the outside row.
Heath Alvey in seven, that will bring him to green. 20 laps will be the distance. One to go signal, veteran chief starter, Terry Gillenwater. And they'll come out of turn number four to the cone. And we're going to turn them loose.
First time people we have here. First time people we have here.
Did you ask that question? Yeah, I did earlier. I seen a few hands.
Out of four, they'll bring them to the line, and we're back underway. Here we go. Into turn number one, down the back straightaway they go. Thart digs hard on the bottom, but it's going to be Albie down the back straightaway using the top side. Smith to third out of four. Lap number one's going to go to Dandridge, Tennessee's Heath Albie. All kinds of sideways out of turn number four for Tyler Smith. He'll hold third. And Carey's going to loop it in one and two. Caution. Going to come out. So caution out, tough break for the third starter, Ryan Carey, in triple five, and he'll loop it in turn number one on his own. Out of four, Heath Albie will bring us back to green, and we are underway. Tharp looks to the inside as they go into turn number one. Good battle down the back straightaway. Smith is third. Mitchell now will go to fourth around Jarnigan. Into three. Tharp digging hard on the bottom. Albie through the middle. Down the front straightaway. It's still Albie at the line by a car length. Into one. Tharp trying to work the bottom. Slipped up just a little bit. It's going to cost him about three car lengths. Smith now works the middle in turn number three and four. He's third. Fourth is Mitchell. And good battle between Ray Jarnigan and the 18 of Summers. Back down the back. Heath Albie starting to pull away just a little bit as they go into three and four. Ducks it off the top side down through the bottom in three and four. And man, oh man, puts a lot of time in the 35 of Thart as they go back down the back straightaway. It's about, oh, five car lengths now back to the 35 of Thart. Pulls well off of turn number two. Struggles just a little bit in three and four. So it appears that Albie may be better in three and four. Tharp a little better in one and two. As I go down the back straightaway, you see Tharp get that good run on him again. Smith is still third, Mitchell fourth, and we got a car hard in the backstretch wall. And the caution is out. With the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Model Series 525 Super Late Models. Make sure to mark that on your calendar. Green is out. Albie ducks quickly to the bottom down in turn number one. Tharp works it as well. And Adam Mitchell's going to lose a couple of spots in the bottom. Yeah, Smith will hold on to third. Jarnigan back to fourth around. Adam Mitchell. And look out, Bubba Long gets sideways in turn number four. Good save. Now battle for second. Down the back straightaway, Smith looked to the low side of Tharp. Not going to happen. Into three. This will put seven laps in the books, 13 laps to go. Heath Albie looks to be locked and loaded today in seven. Matt Tharp trying to run him down the back straightaway. He started to move towards the top of the speedway. Right along the just the edge of the wetter dirt at the top, and he is starting to run down Heath Albie quickly. Almost 0.4 of a second faster that lap. Out of turn number four, the Luttrell Leadfoot's got it to the floor, running down the seven of Albie. Nine laps in the books, 11 laps to go as they'll go down the back straightaway. Smith still third, good battle for fourth now between Mitchell and Jarnigan. Out of four. Halfway at the start-finish line, 10 to 10 laps to go. Matt Tharp has caught Dandridge, Tennessee's Heath Albie. We've got a race into three and out of four. Down the front straightaway, using the top side. He's better in one and two. Into one. Down the back straightaway, he pushed just a little bit that time, but he gets a good run down the back. Into three. Tyler Smith's watching it all unfold from the podium position as they'll roll down the front straightaway. It's 12 in the books. We're a dozen in, eight to go down the back. Lap traffic could potentially be a factor if we stay green, maybe a couple of cars. Albie continues to work the bottom, and it's Tharp in the top. Two different grooves here at Volunteer today. Good racetrack conditions for daytime racing. Here comes Tharp with a crossover down to the inside of three. Out of four, he's going to throw the elbow. You've got a new leader, the Luttrell Leadfoot to the top. Six laps to go. Albie will go back to the bottom, down the back straightaway. Tharp with a rocket ship off of turn number two. Now he'll go to the bottom in three and out of four. Ran him down and got him. Five laps to go. Started dead last in the classic feature. Ran it all the way up to third and now takes the lead with six laps to go in the Sportsman feature. out of four. Problems for your leader right in front of the lap car. Richard Atkins loops it in front of Matt Tharp. Matt Tharp keeps it going, and the caution will come out. How about it? Worked over Heath Alvey. Took the five laps to go for the Luttrell Leadfoot out of turn number four. He'll bring them to the cone, and we're back underway. They both go back to the top in turn number one. They'll race down the back straightaway. Good run for both of them. Here comes Adam Mitchell to the bottom for fourth. That's the only side-by-side battle. Here comes Heath Alvey. He'll look to the inside out of turn number four. Four laps to go into one and two. Alvey's decided he wants to work the bottom now. Tharp down the back straightaway, keeping it going. It'll be three laps to go out of turn number four this time. And they'll come to the line. Three laps to go for the Luttrell Leadfoot. Now Tyler Smith starting to run down Heath Alvey down the back straightaway. Adam Mitchell will pick up the fourth spot from the 773 of Ray Jarnigan. And it'll be a pair of laps to go for Matt Tharp. Into one, down the back straightaway, Tyler Smith holding it well down the back straightaway in 32 as he tries to run down Heath Alvey. White flag in the air, one lap to go for the Luttrell Leadfoot. Down the back straightaway for the final time, Heath Alvey. Not going to have enough here at Volunteer today as they'll come out of turn number four. He's got a third. Now he's got a win. Matt Tharp will go to victory lane in 35. Second will be Heath Alvey. Third for the 32 of Tyler Smith. Fourth for Adam Mitchell. And fifth for Ray Jarnigan. So Ray Jarnigan will settle for a top five spot today. Fourth will go to Adam Mitchell. Third to Tyler Smith. Good run, but second for Heath Alvey in seven. And your winner in car number 35. The Luttrell Leadfoot took the lead on lap number 14. He'll get the win today in the Sportsman Late Models. How about it for Luttrell, Tennessee's Matt Tharp? Unstrapping all his gear, getting ready to climb out of the race car and celebrate today's big win in the Sportsman, third in the Classic from the tail. Good run today, how about it? As he'll drop the window net. And climb out of the car, your winner at Luttrell, Tennessee, the Luttrell Leadfoot, Matt Tharp. As we get set, 17 cars. Lane Clifton and Dakota Knuckles will bring them to green at a turn number four next time for 25 laps. Carter Miller and the Milkman in row number two, Reuben Mayfield, won the limited late model Ice Bowl this year at Talladega Short Track, and beside him it's veteran Bobby Mays out of four. They'll bring them to green, and we're underway with a limited late model feature in a turn number one. Down the back straightaway, Dakota has to get out of the gas. Lane Clifton will take the lead. Rockets out of turn number two. Side by side into turn number three and out of four. Who's going to lead lap one? It'll be Ewing, Virginia's Dakota Knuckles at the line by 41 one-thousandths of a second. Down the back straightaway, the Milkman is taking third from Carter Miller in 69. Good side by side battle for the lead out of turn number four. Racing hard into turn number one, Dakota's got the lead now over the 23 of Lane Clifton down the back straightaway. The Milkman still third. Carter Miller works in fourth, and fifth is Bobby May. Side by side for sixth is Reuben Mayfield, and the Forest Flyer, Walker Arthur in 87. Down the back straightaway, don't look now, but I believe the Milkman's got a piece working over Lane Clifton to the outside, out of turn number four, down the front straightaway. Slipped up a little down the back straightaway. That Longhorn is rolling today. Carter Miller back to the bottom at one and two. Up the high banks down the back straightaway. Dakota Knuckles now with about a five car length lead in 21K. Five laps in the books. Down the back straightaway, Dakota Knuckles continues to lead. It's Lane Clifton in 23 second. Third is the Milkman. Mike Weeks in 37, fourth is Carter Miller in fifth. is the 25 of Bobby Mays. Gonna creep into lap traffic here in just a couple of laps. Now seven laps in the boots. It'll be 18 to go for your leader, Dakota Knuckles. Floyd Self and Dale Reed side by side towards the back of the field as Dakota Knuckles closes in on lap traffic. No change in your top five. Lane Clifton starting to work the middle of the speedway. And the Milkman is now swapped and went to the bottom in 37. Down the back straightaway. Dakota will get by the first of the back markers in Dale Reed. Into three and out of four. Lane Clifton in 23 down the front straightaway. Trying to work by Reed as well. It's still one lap car. Dakota Knuckles will get by the three of Self, who's on the bottom of the speedway. Almost a little contact out of turn number two. Carter Miller works to the inside of the Milkman. And it's still Mike Weeks third in the K37. Down the back straightaway, most of the lap car starting to fall towards the bottom of the speedway as Dakota Knuckles will work to the outside. And 11 laps in the books now, 14 laps to go. Down the back straightaway, they'll go again. Modified street to staging, modified street to staging. This is your final call. Modified street to staging. Heavy lap traffic for Dakota Knuckles. As that's going to allow the 23 of Clifton to close in. Into turn number one and two, it's about five car lengths down the back straightaway. And Knuckles finds a way to get around the Dandridge, Tennessee veteran, Warren McMahon. Side by side, look out. Mitchell Burke gets sideways, almost made contact. That's going to cost the Milkman, and he'll lose third. Problems in one and two. Look out. Carter Miller hard in the wall. He collects the 25. Big crash in turn number one and two. Big problems in turn number one and two as Carter Miller has slapped the outside wall. Driver's side first, hard contact. Bobby Mays having a great run today is collected as well. It all started out of turn number four lap cars. Got McMahon. Side by side, look out. Mitchell Burke gets sideways, almost made contact. That's going to cost the Milkman, and he'll lose third. Problems in one and two. Look out. Carter Miller hard in the wall. He collects the 25. Big crash in turn number one and two. Big problems in turn number one and two as Carter Miller is out of four. It'll bring us back to green. We're underway. Big stack up on the restart. And Dale Ball tries to take advantage as he'll dive to the bottom. Look at, and caution is going to come out. Got a spinner out of turn number four. Caution is out for Brian Shockley. Tazewell, Tennessee driver loops out of turn number four. He hit 21K Dakota Knuckles. Will bring us back to green out of turn number four. Lane Clifton will work, looking at the low side down the back straightaway. Can't get it up, Milkman. Third, fourth is Mayfield, and now Forest Virginia's Walker Arthur has made it up to the fifth spot. He'll look to the inside of Ruben Mayfield down the front straightaway. They'll go side by side for the fourth spot. As a real towards turn number one. Down the back straightaway. Problems. Dale Ball's going to loop in one and two. And Hunter Best just made it to seventh in 007. We're back underway. Back into one and two. Here comes the Milkman digging to the bottom. Down the back straightaway, trying to make a delivery down the back straightaway. Couldn't get it done. They'll race into turn number three and four. The Forest Flyer looks to the inside for fourth again. It's still Dakota Knuckles. 10 laps to go. And now Walker Arthur will get the fourth spot from the 00 Ruben Mayfield. Starting to charge towards the front is the Forest Flyer, Walker Arthur, in 87. Down the back straightaway. Into three and out of four to be eight laps to go with the line this time for Dakota Knuckles. 23 of Lane Clifton now. Trying to work the top side of the speedway. He's pulled away from the Milkman. Arthur is fourth. Fifth is Ruben Mayfield. Seven laps to go. Trying to wrap this one up for Dakota Knuckles. may make it back to lap traffic. As we approach the 5 lap to go mark. Problem for Lane Clifton, pushed way up the hill. He tagged the wall out of four, but he'll keep it going. That cost him some real estate. Dakota may have done the same thing, but not quite to the effect that it was for Lane Clifton. Now he gets it rotated in three and four that time. As Dakota Knuckles is going to enter lap traffic, less than 5 laps to go. What a hot rod that 21K has been all day long. Out of four, it'll be 3 laps to go at the line as they work through lap traffic. Don't look now, but here comes the milkman. Starting to run down the 23 for the runner-up position. Walker Arthur sits firmly in fourth, and fifth is a double zero or MMA field. Two laps to go for Ewing, Virginia's Dakota Knuckles. As he works through lap traffic out of turn number four, white flag in the air from Terry Gillenwater, 1 lap to go. Down the back straightaway for the last time in the limited late models. The milkman trying to make a last ditch effort, but up front it's all Dakota Knuckles. He will win the Volunteer Speedway opener in 21K. Second will go to Lane Clifton, third to the 37 of the milkman Mike Weeks, fourth to Walker Arthur, and fifth to Reuben Mayfield. So the 2017 Ice Bowl champion will round it up in fifth. Reuben Mayfield, fourth, goes to Walker Arthur. Third to the milkman, Mike Weeks. Second to Lane Clifton. And your winner, it'll Ewing, Virginia, in car number 21K. It'll be Dakota Knuckles. And he'll try to clear the scales, and we'll see him in the front straightaway. Ran the Frostbuster last week, had a good outing. Looked very strong in a strong field of super late models at 411. Today brings his own equipment to the Volunteer Speedway, gets it done as he unstraps and to get ready to climb out. Drops the window net. Ladies and gentlemen, today's limited late model winner out of Ewing, Virginia. How about it for Dakota Knuckles?
Not good, honey.
So Austin Atkins in 14 and Wayne Rader in 0-1. Row number two, the Wizard of Oz, John Cook. And the 27 of Charlie Bates. The front three rows, they'll bring them to green out of turn number four. And we are underway. Austin Atkins will grab the lead up in turn number one and go down the back straightaway. Rader will sit in second. Bates is going to get third over the Wizard of Oz. Into turn number three and four. Parrotsville, Tennessee's Blake Kelly. Oil slide to the outside of the Wizard down the back straightaway looking for fourth. Ferguson sixth. Then it's Banks seventh and Reed in eighth in the 17. Top two starting to break away a little bit. Then it's just a gaggle of race cars down the front straightaway, jockeying for third through seventh. Look out, Blake Kelly's going to spin. He's going to collect Jeff Ferguson. Hard hit for Tony Reed. Caution is out. Blake Kelly got loose at the top of turn number one. He looped Jeff Ferguson with nowhere to go, and Tony Reed in for good measures. And it'll bring the caution out again. Again for third through seventh. Look out, Blake Kelly's going to spin. He's going to collect Jeff Ferguson. Hard hit for Tony Reed. Caution is out. Blake Kelly got loose at the top of turn number one. He loosed
inside for the Dixie double file restart
out of turn number four. 18 laps to go, and we're back underway. Air Volunteer. Charlie Bates a little bit slow in the restart as they go down the back straightaway. They're three wide for fifth behind them. The Wizard's going to pay the price and fall to seventh. Ferguson. Now as Tracy Wolf will move up into the fourth spot from the tail end. Got here late in 11, and he's moved up to fourth. Down the back straightaway, side-by-side for fifth is Ferguson and Banks. And Banks gets sideways in four. He'll save it. We'll keep going as Tracy Wolf looks to the inside of Bates in one and two. Down the back straightaway. Still side by side for third. It's all Austin Atkins up front in 14. And now Tracy Wolf will work by the 27 of Charlie Bates and take over third. Out of turn number four, they'll complete six laps on the board. It'll be 14 to go for the 14 of Austin Atkins. Wayne Rader, former Open Wheel Modified competitor here at the High Banks, running a strong second and 01. Third is Tracy Wolf, who's now moving up to challenge for second. Wow, what an outing for Tracy Wolf. Got here late, starting to challenge for second down the back straightaway. Problems in one and two, got a car around. It's the 0-3 of Floyd Humphrey and we'll go yellow. Out of four, he'll bring us back to green. Tracy Wolf did not get the restart he expected as they go into turn number one. Wayne Rader off the top, down the back straightaway, but Wolf with a good run through the bottom of one and two, down the back straightaway, and he will take second side by side. Out of four, you've got a new second place car. It's Tracy Wolf in 11. In a one and two, Austin Atkins down the back straightaway. And he may face his fiercest challenge of the day now as we approach the halfway mark. As Wayne Rader starts to battle his way back to the outside as they go back into turn number one. Down the back straightaway, Charlie Bates fourth and 27, and Banks has made it to fifth in the three. Austin Atkins starting to pull away now, maybe. Tracy Wolf pushes way hard up into turn number one. Down the back straightaway, they'll go. Wayne Rader look to the inside, trying to challenge for the lead. Austin Atkins is checking out. Looks like the handling on Tracy Wolf's car has gone south. Maybe having a little issue with the tire sealing over during that caution as he's starting to push up the hill. And now it's going to be a battle for second. Austin Atkins out front, all to his lonesome. Tracy Wolf trying to hold on in second. Wayne Rader looks to the inside. Charlie Bates watches it all unfold from fourth, and fifth is still Banks. Ferguson trying to work into the top five down the back straightaway. And problems in turn number one and two. We got a car off the pace at the top. It's Caleb Trent. And he may bring out the caution. And the caution is out. So Caleb Trent out of power in three. Looks like he may roll it to the infield. To wrap it up, Tracy Wolf laying back just a little bit. They'll come out of four and get back on it. We're underway. Down the back straightaway, Rader tried to look to the inside, could not get enough grip to pull up alongside with Austin Atkins. Now Wolf trying to hold on in third. And then it's a gaggle from fourth on back. Charlie Bates, Banks in, John Cook in the zero.
Tracy Wolf starting to reel in the 0-1 of Wayne Rader now in 3 and 4 as they'll go down the front straightaway. And you're going to have a battle for second as we go into turn number one. Tracy Wolf down the back straightaway, looks to the outside of Wayne Rader. He's got to run into 3. Austin Atkins starting to pull away, and you may have a shift for second. Gets a good run out of 4th. Side by side down the front straightaway as they go into 1, less than 5 laps to go. Good race for second. Down the back straightaway, it'll be 3 to go when Austin Atkins hits the stripe this time. Side by side for second down the front straightaway. And Tracy Wolf has got the line on Wayne Rader. Down the back straightaway, it'll be double sticks. Problems into turn number 1. Tony Reed and Jeff Ferguson have crashed. Austin Atkins trying to hold on for his first victory of the year. Here we go. Wayne Rader will look to the inside, not going to be able to get it done down the back straightaway. Tried. Brandon Crawford is hard in the wall in turn number 1. And caution is going to have to come out. Brett Banks in the 3, out of 4. Austin will drop off the high banks of the gap, and we're back underway. 3 laps to go. Down the back straightaway. Bates will look to the inside of Wolf, not going to get it done. Big run down the back straightaway. We got problems. Brett Banks has problems and collects the Oz. The Wizard of Oz has got problems, and he'll go to the infield with 2 laps to go. Brett Banks in 3. Going to try to roll it to the infield as they come out of turn number 4. White flag in the air. 1 lap to go for Austin Atkins. Banks will make it to the infield with mechanical problems. Tough break, a top 5 run gone south. Down the back straightaway for the final time. Wayne Rader has slipped way back and out of turn number 4 to be Morristown, Tennessee's Austin Atkins, who will pick up his first win of 2017. Second will go to Wayne Rader. Third, too close to call. Charlie Bates gets it at the line over Tracy Wolf. By 13 one-thousandths of a second, it's Charlie Bates for third at the line. Over the 11 of Wolf, second goes to Wayne Rader. And your winner at Morristown, Tennessee. Here comes number 14, it will be Austin Atkins. Had a rocket ship all day long. He was fast last week before mechanical problems. And now he's going to unstrap and get ready to climb out of the car. Race fans, as you head out, be sure, please be careful headed home. We thank you so much for joining us today at Volunteer Speedway. And there he comes crawling out, Morristown, Tennessee's Austin Atkins, your winner. Big win for Austin Atkins. Congratulations. Race fans, please be careful headed home. Thank you so much for coming out for today's fan appreciation. And to kick off the 2017 season, we look forward to a great season. We hope you enjoyed today's program, and we will see you back here in 3 weeks, March 25th, our next event here at Volunteer Speedway.